Today I have the pleasure of speaking with Henry Weingarten from the Astrologer Fund. How are you today, Henry?
We're doing great, thanks.
Can I just say the skies look wide open there for you? Very exciting behind
you. Yeah, it's the Galactic Center.
Excellent. Okay.
The source of information.
Speaking of the Galactic Center, you told us August was going to be a bit of a challenge.
It was a little early. It was September 2nd, but we were well prepared, and we got it the 10% we expected. Not quite the way we expected it, but it made money if you had the right instruments.
Well, of course, you know, you did make some predictions, of course, which were correct. But we're all looking into November right now with so much uncertainty in the market. Lots of uncertainty. Is there any certainty that the stars are giving you?
Fortunately not. The last one was last Friday when we had the down move, which we correctly saw, but it didn't go down enough. At which point, we have to join everyone else and to say the only certain thing there is that things will remain uncertain. So for the next 30 days, we're somewhat liquid. We initially had 100% protection to our portfolios. We covered it to 50% because it can go either way. We're doing a little bit of day trading here, but we're actually waiting till afterwards. The only certainty we have, and you'll love hearing this, is that November and December, gold will do very well no matter who wins. So that is definite. We of course have a lot of gold and silver, but we're trying to pick up some more. Right now it's playing with the 1900. We had two tests of 1850. We were expecting that. We may break it a little bit, and if it is, we're buying. If we don't break it, we're still buying over the next week or two. October 30th to November 3rd, you don't need to be an astrologer to know that things are going to be very hairy, very volatile, and you've got to either stand aside or trade it every 5 seconds.
Okay, so let me just understand. If I want to be certain, I like gold. Is that correct?
Yes, for November and December. October could still be a little bit down, another $30, $50.
Okay, but let me throw something at you. Cryptocurrency, say I'm a millennial and I understand technology and I don't understand gold. What are we looking at for those of you looking at crypto assets? Come on, Henry.
I hate to say, you know, periodically we've made a lot of money shorting it. We don't like it. We think it's a fraud. But as long as people love it, it will stay up. I haven't looked at it. If it gets above 12,000, we'll look at where we should short it.
Okay.
It's not good long term, in my opinion.
We have you on record saying Trump is going to win.
Yes. We still have that view, although it's scary, to put it on mildly.
Okay. So Trump's still going to win, or?
Yeah, they would say 85%, but it's going to be very last minute. It would be a surprise, which shows up in his horoscope. But I think people will be surprised. Now, regardless, as a market professional, I'm prepared either way if the case were wrong. And the problem that people don't realize, should Trump lose, then markets are likely to retest the March lows somewhere in the next 6 months, if Trump loses.
So let's talk then about the pandemic for a minute, can we? Do you mind?
We can talk. I'm not an expert, but we can talk.
All right.
I don't wear a mask very much.
So there's an onslaught, a near cavalcade of solutions, protection, disinfection, vaccination, everything on the market. And everyone's calling me, telling me they're going to solve the COVID-19 challenge. What are you seeing for those stocks?
It reminds me that when we go into healthcare, that we've seen over 200 to 300 cures for cancer. Now, clearly, some companies like Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson will benefit. I mean, those aren't like major plays, but over the next year, they'll benefit. As for the rest, there'll be two or three winners, and the rest will fall by the wayside. On the other hand, they all got a lot of funding, so it helped them in their research. But most of them won't make it, of course.
Well, what I'm really curious about, I'm sure anyone who follows you, Henry, is curious about, is you must have a gem in there you're dying to share with us. Palladium, the executive order from the White House last week on critical materials and supply chain.
Yeah, that was good for you. I know that. You love that area. So that moved that up. But, you know, the truth is, you know, lithium is going to double, you know, in 2022. And these things will go well. But that was definitely a boost short term for the stocks. But the actual use of them won't be for another year or two. But if you don't mind holding, it's a great buy. But you got to hold. Look at one of our positions like Piedmont. Now, that went up five times because of their announcement with Tesla. Now, you could have held it, you know, for the last year and done well, or you could have waited. But, you know, that's what these other stocks are. So you're in the right space, but you might have to wait a year or two.
Russian suspension agreement, finalization earlier this week, impact on uranium. What are you seeing for all of us uranium folks out there?
Unfortunately, you know, I'm SRI investor and we don't do uranium. And just with the election, will oil do better? And by the way, oil's fairly decent next year, so it's probably good for Trump, whereas it won't be as good if Biden comes in, where obviously alternate energy will do better, although alternate energy will do well. So we've just released that we think it will go roughly from 40 to 50 with an average value of 45. But when it hit 36 last week, we said this is the time to buy, made a quick 10% in a week, which is what we're doing at the moment. Very short-term trading because it's totally unknown even for us, because the influence is astrological and not that strong in the next 20 days.
Okay. So just for fun, I'm going to ask you about six different market sectors very quickly, and I'm going to throw you for a couple of loops. Number one, I have a gentleman I was speaking to that's talking to me about how the energy drink industry in the United States was $14 billion last year. So energy drink stocks, up or down, or don't know?
Don't know.
Okay. I have an interview with a freight tech company in a few minutes. Logistics, do you know anything about that, or did that pop up in your...
We prefer security and computer security because I think that's more of an issue. Logistics will do well, of course, but I think computer security may do better.
Okay, so let's talk about computer security for a second, because I can tell you for the record, we were reviewing whether or not we had been hacked yesterday and blew about, I don't know, 7 billable hours of my time on that. Henry, so I'm assuming that computer hackware, for instance, all good, or what are you seeing?
Yeah, generally good. Obviously, people, there's a lot of reasons it's good, yes.
Okay, and then military applications. Let's go there, because with all of this uncertainty, of course, what's happening in Armenia, let's talk.
Okay, the truth is China is going to be very, we haven't released this, but we're going to release this in our December 2nd year-end forecast for next year. China's going to be very belligerent next year, no surprise, but it's going to be very belligerent. That will help military stocks. China's also going to be in a lot of trouble financially in their October 1st annual chart. So you have to watch out, number one, for owning Chinese and Chinese-related things, but obviously the military and security will be front and center next year, unfortunately.
Well, in addition to sending telegraphs, what should we anticipate from Russia?
Tell me who wins and I'll give you the answer.
Okay, Henry, as always, it's a real pleasure. And for those of you out there in Investor Intel land that would like to ask Henry a question directly or get more involved, send us a note. We'll get it to Henry and we'll definitely ask him. And then, Henry, do you have anything else you'd like to add?
Yes, right after the election, we'll be able to say a lot more firm things about what's going to happen to the end of the year. We're not going to be so vague. We have some things to say in November to December. Unfortunately, here, we're like everybody else.
As always, Henry, it's a real pleasure. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you.